In today's automotive landscape, car seat systems are evolving into marvels of technology, particularly in the premium and luxury segments. Gone are the days of simple heated seats. Now, modern car seats boast active cooling, ventilation systems powered by the vehicle's AC, and even pneumatic air cushions for a massage-like experience. Enter SimScale, the cloud-native simulation platform that empowers engineering teams to elevate their design process. With SimScale, teams gain a competitive advantage through rapid and iterative simulation, guiding their car seat designs to perfection. But what sets SimScale apart? Firstly, SimScale offers seamless collaboration features, allowing teams to work together effortlessly, regardless of geographical location. Additionally, with unlimited parallel simulations, engineers can explore various parameters and scenarios concurrently, accelerating the design iteration process. Moreover, SimScale provides real-time customer support, ensuring that engineers receive assistance precisely when they need it. And perhaps most importantly, SimScale boasts a user-friendly interface, making simulation accessible to engineers of all levels of expertise. But what can SimScale do for car seat design specifically? SimScale serves as the ultimate solution, offering a comprehensive range of simulations to address every aspect of car seat engineering. From structural simulations assessing integrity and strength under static, dynamic, vibrational, or thermal loads, as you can see here on the left, to CFD simulations accurately predicting airflow and heat transfer for ventilated seats, as you can see here on the right. SimScale covers it all. Now let's dive into the platform and witness firsthand how SimScale revolutionizes car seat engineering. Join us as we explore the future of automotive design with SimScale. This is the SimScale workbench. As you can see from the address bar, it operates entirely within your web browser, eliminating the need for software installation and maintenance. Today we'll compare two car seat designs using thermal simulation. Design 2 features more smaller ventilated air outlets compared to design 1, but both designs share identical cold air intake from under the seat. The cold air has 16 degrees centigrade, and we're defining a flow rate of 10 liters per minute. A heat source represents the heat brought into the system from the passenger. We're primarily interested in the temperature distribution across the seats, but the simulation will also provide results on airflow velocities, pressure differences or pressure drops, and flow structures. The first step involves selecting the appropriate analysis type. Since we're dealing with combined heat transfer through solids and fluids, we'll choose conjugate heat transfer. This generates a simulation tree on the left side. And by completing each step in this tree, we'll turn the red markers into green check marks, indicating a successful setup. There are just three remaining steps: defining the direction of gravity, assigning material properties, and setting the boundary conditions we discussed earlier. Let's walk through these steps now. Once the green check marks confirm a complete setup, we can initiate the simulation. SimScale's parallel processing allows you to run multiple simulations simultaneously, which can save you massive amounts of time. For example, if a single simulation takes 10 minutes, running 5 simulations will also take 10 minutes, as each runs on a separate virtual machine. SimScale's CAD swapping feature simplifies exploring different design options. By duplicating the current setup and selecting a new geometry, design 2 in this case, the materials, boundary conditions, and other settings are automatically transferred or reassigned. You only need to hit run to start the simulation with the new design. All right, simulations are done. Let's delve into the results. Remember, we can visualize pressure and flow speeds within the seat's air channels. So here we can see the pressure distribution and the pressure difference between the inlets and all the different outlets. By looking at the flow structure, we can identify areas with recirculation, like near the inlets or near the headrest. This helps us optimize airflow by potentially adjusting the inlet design or vent placement. Now, the key metric is the temperature distribution on the seating surfaces. Here we see temperatures reaching around 28 degrees centigrade, potentially causing discomfort. To improve this, we could simulate a higher cold airflow using, for example, a stronger fan. Or let's compare this design with design 2, which had more vents. So we can set them here side by side. As expected, design 2 shows a more even and comfortable temperature distribution. Now, while here they're at 28 degrees on design 1, design 2, it's significantly lower. And so this is how engineers can use SimScale to inform and guide their designs and decisions. Thank you very much for joining.